How did she react when she heard it?
She broke in his ears.
Don't wanna get ahead of myself, feeling things I've never felt. It's kind of hard for me to explain her personality in everything.
Well,
what up? Nice to meet you too.
Thanks,
man.
Thanks so much for doing this.
Of course.
So much of the interviews you've done over the last couple of years, a lot of it focuses in on your style. You're known for these incredible, beautiful, bespoke suits. But I was reading a whole bunch of old interviews, and I actually want to ask you about a t-shirt that you made in high school, which had the picture of three murdered civil rights workers on it. Do you remember the t-shirt?
Wow, that's great. I do. I love that photo. You know, it's like I was really always fascinated with, you know, amazing, you know, history like that. As a kid, you know, my dad made sure that we would always celebrate the civil rights martyrs. It's important to know, you know, where we came from. You really take pride in knowing the people who were brave and stood up for, you know, our freedom. And that's the thing I love most about the soul style of music was black people around that time, that was all they could cling to in the midst of discrimination and racism, you know, and so it really pushed out amazing artistry.
At the age of 16, she found Christ at an altar. All along he was calling her name.
Lisa Sawyer is a song that has a pretty significant role in both your life and your career. It is about your mum, I understand.
It is.
Can you take me back to the day that song was written? What was going through your head as you wrote that song?
You know, I wanted to make a song that was that honored my mother. And I mean, even when I wrote it, you know, I never even showed my mother.
Really?
It took like a friend of mine. We were sitting together at the crib and she was like, "Hey, play that song you wrote about your mama." And I was like, I kept her.
How long did you think you could hide it from her, though?
Yeah, I know, exactly.
Like, she's gonna find it eventually. Yeah. How did she react when she heard it?
She broke in his ears. And she, for one, didn't know that I could sing or write songs. Yeah.
My darkness, I remember mama's words reoccur to me. Surrender to the good Lord. You know, wipe your slate clean.
Were they always supportive of you kind of exploring music as a career, or was that like a turning point where suddenly like, you should absolutely do that as a career?
At the time, my mother was always supportive, but there were a lot of times to where, you know, I did a lot of things without her knowing it. You know, I was using her car, and so that was my way to the open mics. And I mean, she didn't really want me to be around a lot of the bars, you know, at the time, you know. And so that's why I had to kind of go out and do it without her.
Did I not love enough to keep your attention on and on?
My understanding is that you'd always had an interest in music, but it wasn't until in college there was a cafeteria where there was a piano.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I mean, for me, my first love was dance, and I found music through dance. And I met some musicians who were on campus. And so we'd get together and we'd make up songs about food. You know, that was like the easiest thing to improv about.
You're in a cafeteria, it makes sense,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly. We'd be like, "I love my sandwich with chips on the side." But yeah, that's definitely what sparked my love for songwriting. At the time, I didn't think I was any good at singing. And I met a community of songwriters, and it's good to have that accountability, you know, and surround yourself with people who are better than you, you know.
Don't let them know that, though. They can never know.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's healthy, and if it wasn't for that, I wouldn't even be where I'm at now.
I don't want more. I just wanna be a better man to my baby. Give me all good love.
You hear everybody singing along to, you know, to the album, and that's just a super dope thing. It shows that I guess I make good music.
I think we can safely agree that at this stage of your career, yes, definitely you make great music.
Thank you so much. Maybe I'm leaving here with nothing.
I think people were drawn to my story. when you look at me being a black kid from Fort Worth, Texas, doing this kind of music is not something you see every day. And for me, the songwriting aspect was more than just making cliche soul music. You know, I wanted to tell my narrative and, you know, my family's narrative through 60s R&B, and that was a statement I wanted to make.
Leon, thanks so much for your time. Really appreciate
you.
It.
Appreciate it.